We will start our problem with a rectangle with the height of 25. Then we will inscribe two circles inside this rectangle so that they are touching at the single point of tangency, just as shown in the sketch. Then, using this point of tangency, we will pull a vertical line that touches both of the arcs of the circle, just as shown in the sketch. And, of course, this line will be parallel to the height of our rectangle. Now, if we know that the length of this line is equal to 16, can we somehow calculate the area of our red rectangle? If you want to try this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So we can start solving this problem by first labeling the point of tangency between two circles as O. Then we can label the both ends of our vertical line as A and B. Now we will use a really interesting property of a circle that states that the perpendicular to a chord drawn from the center of the circle bisects the chord. So, we can use this in our case. If we take a look at the line OB, it represents the chord of our bigger circle. And if we mark the center of this circle and pull the perpendicular bisector to the chord OB, it will divide the line OB into two identical segments, which we can label as X. The same thing applies to our smaller circle. If we take a look at the line OA this time, it also represents the chord of our smaller circle, and as you can see, we have the same situation. If we pull the perpendicular bisector to this chord, it will divide the line OA into two identical segments, which we can label as Y. Now, if we clear our image a little bit, you can see that the segments BO plus OA will get us to the line AB. So, if we substitute our values, we get that 2x plus 2y is equal to 16. Now we can simplify both sides of the equation with 2 and get that x plus y has the length of 8. Now, if you take a look at our sketch again, you can see that this vertical line between two perpendicular bisectors of our two circles is equal to x plus y, which is equal to 8. Alright, so now let's pull the vertical radius for our bigger circle and let's label it as capital R. We will do the same thing for our smaller circle and label its radius as small r. Then, let's also notice the height of our rectangle. Now, if we clear our image a little bit and rearrange the position of those lines, you can see that the sum of capital R, 8 and small r is equal to 25. So this means that the sum of radii of our two circles is equal to 17. Next, we will slide our green line horizontally to the center of our smaller circle. Then, we will rotate both radii of our two circles to their point of tangency. Therefore, we will form the straight line through both centers. But how do we know that this is actually a straight line? Well, the theorem of the circle states that if two circles touch each other externally or internally, then their point of contact lies on the straight line joining their centers. As you can see, this is exactly our case, so therefore, the line between two centers of our circles must be a straight line. Alright, so now we can notice this really nice blue right triangle, whose base we can label as A. Then we can use the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle. We can say that the leg A squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared, which represents the sum of both radii of our circles minus the leg A squared. Now, we know that the sum of our radii is equal to 17, so we will just substitute this value in, we will put everything to the square, and we will get that A squared is equal to 225, which means that the base of this right triangle is equal to 15. Now we will substitute this value of A for our new formed horizontal line. Then let's pull a horizontal radius of our bigger circle and let's do the same thing for our smaller circle. Then let's notice the base of our rectangle and let's label this base as B. Now if we again clear our image and rearrange those lines, you can see that the base of our rectangle is equal to the sum of radii of our two circles and the line with the length of 15. Now again we will substitute the value for the sum of both radii and get that B is equal to 17 plus 15, which means that the base of our rectangle has the length of 32. Now it's pretty easy for us to find the area of the rectangle as the product of the base and the height, so in our case that is 32 times 25, and we will get that the area of our red rectangle is equal to 800 squared units, and this is our solution. Well, I really love this interesting problem, and if you guys feel the same, please leave a like, share it, and consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this in the future. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.